The number of arrests associated with the riot at the U.S. Capitol 2 weeks ago continues to grow. A Michigan man accused of hitting police with a hockey stick is in jail tonight. FBI agents arrested Michael Foy today. Prosecutors say video footage shows him attacking police. Just yesterday, two men from Florida with ties to a far-right extremist group were arrested for taking part in the siege.
Even people with ties to our area have been arrested in connection to the riots. The I-Team's PJ Randhawa looks into what's next for them.
In the wake of the Capitol unrest of January 6th, more than 116 people are now facing federal charges. Near Missouri, that includes Richard Beagle Barnett from Arkansas, seen here in one of the most shocking photos from that day. Closer to home, there's Emily Hernandez of Sullivan, Missouri.
She's a 21-year-old girl, and she's got her whole life ahead of her. She knows that, you know, this was obviously a mistake, but she's ready to move past it.
The 21-year-old turned herself into the FBI this week on charges of disorderly conduct, knowingly entering or remaining in a restricted building, and disruptive conduct in the Capitol buildings. Hernandez was released without bond. No date has been set for her next court hearing. The FBI are also looking for a man seen here in the same photo as Hernandez, and he could be local as well. He's seen wearing a Blues hat. With the possibility of a presidential pardon off the table, St. Louis attorney Al Watkins is lining up his client's defense strategy.
Let's roll the tape. Let's roll the months of lies and misrepresentations and horrific innuendo and hyperbolic speech by our president designed to inflame, enrage, motivate.
Watkins is representing perhaps the most recognizable figure from the unrest, 33-year-old Jacob Chansley, also known as the QAnon Shaman. Watkins says President Trump's inaction was a wake-up call for some, including his client.
He regrets very, very much having not just been duped by the president, but by being in a position where he allowed that duping to put him in a position of making decisions that he should not have made.
Attorney Al Watkins tells me several people involved in the Capitol unrest have reached out to him for representation. He says as a matter of practice, he can't say any more than that. Now, we were able to get a hold of the man in the Blues hat in some of those pictures we showed you. He told me he has nothing to say about that. For the I-Team, PJ Randhawa, 5 on your side.